Sounds great. No, it doesn't, because it's out of tune. It's out of tune. And we're going to talk a little bit about tuning now, because you need to be in tune. And it's an easy thing to do. These electronic tuners are fabulous, and they're easy to use, but there are some fine points. To start with, an acoustic guitar is not a precise instrument. It varies a lot from guitar to guitar and from under different playing styles as you play up the neck or whether or not you capo as I do. So there are also different strings have different tendencies in terms of how they harmonize back and forth. Over a period of time, I've come up with a method of tuning the guitar that really seems to address some of these conflicts that are part of the instrument. And what I would recommend is buying an electronic tuner that has, aside from some indicator that tells you when you're on the note so that you can get up to the right note, also has this sense feature. Now, a cent is 1/100th of a half step. So it's just a tiny increment of sharpness or flatness. And if you buy a tuner that's got a cent feature that'll tell you how many cents sharp or flat you are, then you can calibrate your tuning to compensate for some of the vagaries and the inconsistencies in the instrument. What are those vagaries and what cause them? Well, one thing is that bass strings tend to, when you play them hard, they ring sharp. So they'll tend to want to be a little bit flatter, relatively speaking. And the B string, for some reason, needs to be flat relative to what you would think of as being its A440 dead on pitch. That's just the way the instrument is. So I'm going to show you what we do. When we tune a high E string, we tune it 3 cents flat of what would be considered spot on. -3. The B string, we tune it to -6. It seems like a lot, but the G string is -4. The D string we tune to -8. The A string gets -10. And the low E string gets a full -12 cents. And now this sort of wide tuning, where the bass strings are as much as 12 cents flat, and the high E string is almost all the way up to right on it, that compensates for the capo pulling the whole instrument a little bit sharp. It compensates for the bass strings tending to ring sharper than they actually are. Sometimes for the bass strings, it's best to play a harmonic. Can you hit the on button for us again? This machine has a couple of infuriating things about it. Thank you. So again, that's it. Minus three for the E string, minus six for the B string, minus four for the G string, minus eight for the D string, minus 10 for the A, and a full minus 12 for the E string. Check it out. See how it works for your guitar. I think you'll like it.